Good morning, Whitford Parish. Good to be here on this Sunday, the 19th of July. And I'm going to give us a couple of poems from When I Talk to You by Michael Lunig while people arrive. Let it go. Let it out. Let it all unravel. Let it free, and it can be a path on which to travel. Yeah, great image. Here we go. Dear God, it is timely that we give thanks for the lives of all prophets, teachers, healers and revolutionaries, living and dead, acclaimed or obscure, who have rebelled, worked and suffered for the cause of love and joy. We also celebrate that part of us, that part within ourselves, which has rebelled, worked and suffered for the cause of love and joy. We give thanks and we celebrate. There we go. Cute. Reminds me of Jesus in the manger at Bethlehem. The star overhead. We search and yet find no meaning. The search for a meaning can lead to despair. And when we are broken, the heart finds its moment to fly and to feel and to work as it will through the darkness and mystery and wild contradiction. For this is its freedom, its need and its calling. This is its magic, its strength and its knowing, to heal and to make meaning while we walk or lie dreaming, to give birth to love within our surrender, to mother our faith, our spirit and yearning, while we stumble in darkness, the heart makes our meaning and offers it into our life and creation, that we may give meaning to life and creation. For we only give meaning, we do not find meaning. The thing we can't find is the thing we shall give to make love complete and to honour creation. And everywhere he's been, there are little footprints of love behind him, even though he didn't realise it. Cool. We've had that one. We give thanks for our friends, our dear friends. We anger each other. We fail each other. We share this sad earth, this tender life, this precious time. Such richness, such wildness. Together we are blown about. Together we are dragged along, all this delight, all this suffering, all this forgiving life, we hold it together. Amen. There we go, we're up the tree together, holding on. Love the bird as well, singing away over the top of them. That's what they tend to do, isn't it? Sing over the top of us. Right, I hope you found your Sunday service. We're on spiritual communion this week. Good to see lots of you joined us. So the Lord be with you and also with me. Let's worship God together as we sing Shine, Jesus, Shine, which is the first hymn in your sheet, or if you've got the green book, it's 362. Graham Kendrick, 1987, Make Way Music. 362 in your green books. Enjoy. Shine, Jesus, shine.
Lord, the light of your love is shining in the midst of the darkness, shining. Jesus, light of the world, shine upon us. Set us free by the truth you now bring us. Shine on me. Shine on me.
presence, from the shadows into your radiance. By the blood I may enter your brightness. Search me, try me, consume all my darkness. Shine on me. Shine on me.
Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze. Set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow. Flood the nations with grace and mercy. Send forth your word, Lord, and let
And so we turn to our oars of service as we prepare our hearts. We say together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. So let us call to mind and confess our sins together. Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought and word and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen. And Heavenly Father, we thank you for your love and mercy shown to each one of us. May we know your peace. Amen. And a collect from the sheet. Heavenly Father, you anointed your Son Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit and with power to bring to us the blessings of your kingdom. Anoint your church with the same Holy Spirit, that we who share in his suffering and victory may bear witness to the gospel of salvation through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And the collect for the sixth Sunday after Trinity. Creator God, you made us all in your image. May we discern you in all that we see and serve you in all that we do. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. So our Bible readings for today. Our first reading is Jacob's dream, and it comes from Genesis 28, verses 10 to 19a. So that's Jacob's dream, which is in Genesis 28, verses 10 to 19a. Jacob left Beersheba and set out for Haran. When he reached a certain place, he stopped for the night because the sun had set. Taking one of the stones there, he put it under his head and lay down to sleep. He had a dream in which he saw a stairway resting on the earth, with its top reaching to heaven, and the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. There above it stood the Lord, and he said, I am the Lord, the God of your father Abraham, and the God of Isaac. I will give you and your descendants the land on which you are lying. Your descendants will be like the dust of the earth, and you will spread out to the west and to the east, to the north and to the south. All peoples on earth will be blessed through you and your offspring. I am with you and will watch over you wherever you go, and I will bring you back to this land. I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you. When Jacob awoke from his sleep, he thought, "Surely the Lord is in this place, and I was not aware of it." He was afraid and said, "How awesome is this place! This is none other than the house of God. This is the gate of heaven." Early the next morning, Jacob took the stone he had placed under his head and set it up as a pillar and poured oil on top of it. He called that place Bethel. And our New Testament reading is from Matthew's Gospel, chapter 13, verses 24 to 30, and then 36 to 43. So it's Matthew chapter 13, and it's the parable of the weeds, and then the parable of the weeds explained. So it's verses 24 to 30, and then 30 to 43. Jesus told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed good seed in his field. While everyone was sleeping, his enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and then went away. When the wheat sprouted and formed ears, then the weeds also appeared. The owner's servants came to him and said, "Sir, didn't you sow good seed in your field? Where then did the weeds come from?" "An enemy did this," he replied. The servants asked him, "Do you want us to go and pull them up?" "No," he answered, "because while you are pulling up the weeds, you might uproot the wheat with them. Let both grow together until the harvest. At that time, I will tell the harvesters, 'First collect the weeds and tie them in bundles to be burned. Then gather the wheat and bring it into my barn.'" So now Jesus explains the parable. Then he left the crowd and went into the house. His disciples came to him and said, "Explain to us the parable of the weeds in the field." He answered, "The one who sowed the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seed stands for the people of the kingdom. The weeds are the people of the evil one, and the enemy who sows them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the harvesters, they're the angels. As the weeds are pulled up and burned in the fire, so it will be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send out his angels, and they will weed out of his kingdom everything that causes sin and all who do evil. They will throw them into the blazing furnace, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Whoever has ears, let them hear." So these were the words of the Lord. Thanks be to God for his words to us today. Do stay, and after this service, you'll hear Andy preaching from the word, and then Jess will be coming up at the end of that at 12:30 to give us an all-age service to enjoy. We're going to sing again. This time we're going to sing All My Days, which is 1158 in your books, by Stuart Townend, 1998. Thank you, music. All my days I will sing this song of gladness. Give my praise to the fountain of delights, beautiful Saviour, wonderful Counsellor.
Where the glory
So we come into our prayers of intercessions. And I want to start our prayers this morning by remembering Princess Beatrice and her marriage to Eduardo Mapelli Mozzi. And we just pray for them, Lord, that they will find joy in each other's company and in joining those two families together. Keep us, good Lord, when we feel worried or uncertain. Support anyone who is anxious or fearful, and lift up all who are brought low, that we might rejoice in your comfort, knowing that nothing can separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. So we do pray for people who are out of work at the moment. We pray for food banks. Help us to be generous, and those people who need to access them are able to access them. We pray for people who are anxious, not sure what to do. We pray for protection over them, or people who are unwell. Pray for those who are struggling with their mental health at this time, that they would seek support from the medics and from charities that can support them. They would find the solution, someone to talk to, someone to hear them. Lord, we do pray that you will be alive in our world, that people will know you there. They will see you, feel your presence, know your comfort. Amen. Merciful God, we bring before you anyone who is ill or struggling with pain today. We know that your everlasting arms are there to uphold and support us and keep us safe. Comfort and heal anyone who is unwell, and restore them to health and strength through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We do pray for Brazil, for Latin America. And there are parts of Spain and Barcelona this morning where COVID is spiking again. We pray for the Yemen, who are desperate for PPE and sanitizer. We pray for the many charities that are working so hard to keep people safe and trying to help. World Vision, Tear Fund, Christian Aid are just a few. We pray for those workers as they are prepared to put themselves at risk in order to support and help others. Gracious God, give skill, sympathy and resilience to all who are caring for the sick, and your wisdom to those searching for a cure. Strengthen them with your spirit, that through their work, many will be restored to health. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. O God, help me to trust you. Help me to know that you are with me. Help me to believe that nothing can separate me from your love, that is revealed in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And so today we pray for Don, for Beryl, for Joan and Michael. And we remember the families of David, Emma and Claire, of Joyce Dines, and Heather and Andy Archer. Lord, be with them. Fill them with your spirit. Fill them with the knowledge of your love. Lord, we know that you are there to comfort and heal us, to restore us and bring us new life. So Lord, we just pray that you will draw close to these people and any known to us that we name now in our hearts to you. Lord, we do pray for the many families who are just embarking on school holidays. They probably feel like they've only just finished homeschooling. And so it's pretty much more of the same without the direction. And so, Lord, we just pray for them that they will enjoy the summer holidays, chance to get out, to do picnics and just to get back to the parks and enjoy one another's company. And we pray for teachers who have worked right through this period. We pray that they will have rest after they break up this week. I know they've still got more days to do, so we'll be with them in their studying together, in their preparations for September. And then we pray that they will have had a good rest and be ready for the new term. Amen. And so we pray the prayer for when we cannot get to church. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your disciples, I am with you always. Be with our church family and all those who live in Whitford, Chelmsford, for our neighbours and our friends. Be with me today as I offer myself to you. Hear my prayer for others and for myself. And keep me in your care. Amen. So we join together in saying the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. So, peace to this house from God our Heavenly Father. Peace to this house from his Son, who is our peace. Peace to this house from the Holy Spirit, the life giver. Amen. And we're just going to join together in our spiritual communion, as we still can't meet, or we're not meeting at the moment for communion. Almighty God, in union with the faithful at every altar of your church, where your blessed body and blood are being offered to the Father, I desire to offer you praise and thanksgiving. I present to you my soul and body with the earnest wish that I may ever be united to you. And since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart. I unite myself to you and embrace you with all the affections of my soul. Let nothing ever separate me from you. Let me live and die in your love. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, grant that as the hem of your garment touched in faith, healed the woman who could not touch your body, so the soul of your servant may be healed by faith in you, whom I cannot now sacramentally receive, through your tender mercy, who lives and reigns with the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, ever one God, world without end. Amen. We're going to join together in singing our closing hymn, and it's You Never Let Go by Matt and Beth Redman, 2005 Thank You Music, and it's number 1753 in your book. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, your perfect love is casting out fear. Let's join together in singing You Never Let Go.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, your perfect love is casting out fear.
To remember at a challenging time like this, isn't it, that God never lets go of us, ever. Amazing, awesome God we serve. The blessing. May God, the holy and undivided Trinity, preserve us in body, mind and spirit, and bring us safe to that heavenly country where peace and harmony reign. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among us and remain with us always. Amen. Thank you for joining us. Stay tuned for Andy's sermon and then for the all-age service. Now, I promised to keep reminding us about looking after our planet. So this was recommended to me by Tammy. Don't know if I'm allowed to say the company, but anyway, Cutis is where I got it from. And it's a natural deodorant. This particular one is grapefruit and mandarin. And it's all environmentally friendly. So once it's used up, it's all cardboard cylinder, so no plastic. So to me, that is fantastic. I love it. I'm very pleased with this particular find. Find more things. Let us know. Tell us all about it. We want to look after our planet and our world. Look after each other. God bless. Take care. I hope to see you for coffee. Bye.